Hello all of you. In this video, I'm discussing the formation of the Appalachian Mountains of North America. In one of the earlier papers, there was a question asking you to explain the formation of the Himalayan Mountains of India and also of Appalachian Mountains. And I know most students wrote a very generic answer in terms of plate tectonics about the plates collision, the CC collision, the OC collision, the formation of Appalachians. But I presume if you know a bit more of technical details, it gives you answer a bit of refinement and a bit of technical feel also. So here discussing the Appalachian Mountains of North America. The Appalachians. If you're aware about the map of North America, the Gulf of Mexico, we have the peninsula of Florida, we have parts of northern North America, this is the Hudson Bay. The Appalachian Mountains are along the eastern side of North America. And these mountains and the rocks are known to extend towards Canada, even in parts of island of Newfoundland Island. And these rocks also extend towards parts of Greenland. And there is some resemblance of these rocks in parts of Pennine Mountains and even in parts of Scottish Highlands. So Appalachians are essentially a type of a continuous system, but tectonics and split of continents, when North America got separated from Europe, the Appalachians became a different and a distinct mountain range of North America. This I presume some of which you know. And in fact, the rocks of Appalachians, because they're similar to some of the rocks of UK and of Western Europe, it was used as an evidence to prove that the continents must have been once together. Apart from this, the Appalachian region has a typical structure. The Appalachian area essentially can be divided up into a couple of parts. We have the main ranges. And these main ranges are including a couple of parallel mountains. We have a mountain system called as the Blue Ridge. This was among the first upliftments. We also have a mountain range that is referred to as Allegheny Mountains. This is further toward the east. We have a zone of Appalachians on the west, which is a plateau. This is the Appalachian plateau. The Appalachian plateau in the early Paleozoic times, this zone was known to have forest, dense forest of early Paleozoic, and these forests ultimately converted into the coal fields because of rifting, tectonic processes, change in climate. So this part ultimately has become the coal fields. Further eastwards, we have the zone called as the Piedmont Zone of Appalachians. This is the Piedmont Zone. This is like an elevated large plain, the Piedmont Zone. And beyond the Piedmont Zone is the coastal plains of Eastern North America. So if you talk about the zones of Appalachians, we have the Appalachian Plateau, we have series of mountains here, and then we have a Piedmont Zone, and then we have the coastal plains. This is the Appalachian Plateau, this is the Appalachian Mountains, which includes the Blue Ridge, it includes Allegheny Mountains, it also includes the Great Smokies, and thereafter we have the Appalachian Piedmont Zone. This area, this is a sharp fault. A lot of rivers drain from here. It's also referred to as the fault line in US. Rivers drain here. And this ultimately is the coastal plains of the eastern US. This is approximately the structure of the area of Appalachians. The story of Appalachian formation starts back to the late Precambrian times. I'm talking approximately around 800 million years ago, when North America and Africa, they were all joined together as a part of a very large supercontinent. And somewhere around this time, this supercontinent broke up into two parts to start with. Those tectonics, it broke up into two parts, and an ancestral Atlantic Ocean was formed. This is the old Atlantic Ocean, also called as the ancestral Atlantic Ocean. And somewhere around this time itself, around 700 million years ago, North American part further broke up, and there was a small piece of land, the ancestral Atlantic Ocean, and the rest of Africa. This is North America. This kind of becomes an island strip, and this is Africa. This one is a type of marginal sea, and this is the old, the ancestral Atlantic Ocean. Thereafter, what happened around the same time, the sea of the ancestral ocean starts to witness subduction. So North America, the marginal sea, the island portion which was once of North America somewhere here, this has broken and separated. And the Atlantic Ocean here develops a subduction zone, and this is Africa. And this subduction creates the island arcs, creates the island arcs, the archipelagos. So we have a subduction number one happening around 700 million years ago. Thereafter, what happened was, somewhere around 600 million years ago, the marginal sea also starts to subduct. And while this is subducting, the ancestral ocean continues to subduct also. And this is the remaining part of Africa. So we have subduction one and we have subduction two. As this process continues, somewhere around 500 million years ago, we're talking about the time of the Paleozoic times. What happens in this time is the subduction number two completes, and this remaining part ultimately goes back and fuses with North America. But this time there is a lot of sediments, accretionary prism has formed here, and this is the formation of the Blue Ridge, one of the parts of the Appalachian Mountains. This forms the Blue Ridge Mountains, and this subduction also keeps on continuing. The island arc continues to develop here, and Africa remains separate. And this mountain building, which is the Blue Ridge Mountain building, this is referred to as tectonic origin or orogeny. So what we did, if you want to revise it once with me, we started with a supercontinent around 800 million years ago. This breaks up into North American block and the African block, and an old Atlantic Ocean has formed. Around 700 million years ago, the part of eastern North America breaks up, forming a continental island with a marginal sea in between. And further on this side, there is the old Atlantic Ocean, the ancestral Atlantic Ocean in Africa. And thereafter, somewhere around the same time, the old Atlantic Ocean starts to subduct. Around 600 million years ago, the marginal sea also subducts. And this continental island east of the rest of North American part, this starts to converge and close. The subduction here also goes on. The island archipelago is forming here. But what is distinct is the convergence of the North America and the piece of continent which had separated. Around 500 million years ago, the two blocks converge, and we have the first fold mountain form, which is accretionary prism along with some volcanism here. And this is referred to as the tachonic orogeny. This is the tachonic orogeny, the first phase of the Appalachian mountain building. As this process continues, around 400 million years ago, the part of the archipelago of the ancestral Atlantic Ocean, this comes and collides with the block. So this is the Blue Mountains. A small block of land is here. And then this starts closing in. The archipelago, which was here, this comes and collides with this mountain here. It collides here. And there is the remaining part of the Atlantic Ocean, and Africa is here. So this archipelago has now collided here. This is referred to as the Acadian orogeny. This is the Acadian, A-C-A-D-I-A-N, Acadian orogeny. So we have the tachonic orogeny, which formed the Blue Ridge, and now we have the Acadian orogeny. This is happening somewhere around the late Devonian times. So imagine the complexities involved in this Appalachian. There is an accretionary prism of the melange type. There is a continental block, and this is an archipelago, entirely volcanic. All of this together is in the process of creating the Appalachian Mountains. So we have the tachonic orogeny, which gave us the Blue Ridge, the Acadian mountain, Acadian orogeny, which gives us the remaining part of the eastern Appalachians. Thereafter, somewhere around 350 million years ago, the Atlantic entirely closes. So we're talking about somewhere around the Carboniferous times. The entire Atlantic Ocean has now closed. So what we have is the Blue Ridge part here. We have the continental part here. We have the old accretionary prism. We have the old archipelago part. And we have now another accretionary prism forming, followed by the African part here. This is what becomes the Allegheny Mountains of Appalachian Mountains. And then somewhere around 200 million years ago, by the way, when this is happening, this is the formation of the Pangaea. The supercontinent has been formed, the Pangaea. The formation of Pangaea. Around the early Mesozoic times, the Pangaea now starts breaking up. So the Appalachian, which was formed here, okay, where North American part and the African part have now collided. Now, what happens is this supercontinent now again breaks up, and there's a formation of the new Atlantic Ocean. Breaks up, the formation of the new Atlantic Ocean, and Africa is somewhere farther away. So the structure now includes the Blue Ridge part, the continental part, there is a part of the archipelago, there is an accretionary prism which has fused here, okay. There is a Piedmont zone, this is the coastal plains, and this is the new Atlantic Ocean, And this is Africa. So this is the Appalachian Mountains with its diversity. So we have the Blue Ridge here. We have parts of the Allegheny Mountains here. There are blocks which are continental, and all of this together is the Appalachian Mountains. So it was unusual question where they should have asked details of a mountain. Okay, but they have done so beyond Himalayas. This should give you some idea about how the Appalachian was formed. So if I sum this up, Appalachian Mountains is essentially both. We have features of OO collision and also features of OC collision. And when the African part collided and fused, you also have parts of the CC collision. That is why Appalachian is one of the most complex mountain systems. And if you look at the origin of Appalachian, it happened right through the Paleozoic times. It has continued in the parts of the early Mesozoic times. In the Paleozoic times, the two important phases was through the Silurian and Devonian times, and it also continued through the Carboniferous times. The Carboniferous times feature is what is called as the Hercynian Mountains, and this became part of the Caledonian Mountains. So if you talk about Appalachian Mountains have both features of Hercynian Mountains and also features of Caledonian Mountains. So I hope you have got the hang of the mountain building. It's like a summary on this page. You could pause this page and take down your notes and maybe rewind and listen to this again and have some jottings for you to help you revise. Thank you.